Dzień dobry Państwu, witam right. Państwa
good afternoon.
Po raz drugi.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We meet for the second time today, and this is the last time today. We are giving you the turnout by 5 o'clock. It's going to be Judge Sylwester Marciniak, Deputy Chairman of the Commission, and Judge Arkadiusz Despot Murnowicz, and Judge Krzysztof Strzelczyk, also of the National Electoral Commission. Good afternoon at this conference on the turnout. So I will tell you what is the number of eligible voters and people who have cast the ballots by 5 o'clock for the presidential candidates on May 10. 2015. The Commission, using the data from 25,957 constituencies out of all the regional commissions all over the country, that is, it is 100% of them, we can tell you that by 5 o'clock p.m. today, we have seen the number of eligible voters was 30,229,508 votes. Ballots were given, including the packages and envelopes sent abroad, to 10,422,124 people, which is 34.41% of all the eligible voters. Now, the collective aggregate data in cities over 250,000 population, the highest turnout was in Warsaw, because out of well over 1 million voters, 542,000 cards were issued, which is 34.67%. The lowest turnout was in Bydgoszcz, because out of all the voters eligible, 97,000 people were voting, which is 35.48%. In relation to the eligible voters, most of them went to the polls on 12 o'clock in Kodziszów village in Lublin province, and by 5 o'clock 51.89% went to the polls. And in relation to the eligible people, the lowest turnout was, that has changed, in Cedynia, Western Pomeranian province, where the turnout was 17.35%. Now, you will get these data in a printed press release later on.
Now,
we have not heard any reports of any events that would cause the extension of the election voting time, so the polls will be closed at 9 in the evening, and by that time no opinion, no exit polls can be published. So traditionally, I'll ask you now to ask questions. Hanna Dobrowolska, movement watching the elections. I want to tell you about the fact which is happening now at Śląska 33 Street in Warsaw, where a foreign monitor was not allowed into the building, and a foreign journalist, a Ukrainian journalist and Lithuanian journalists were not allowed in. Instead, they called the police, and I think that is unusual.
Druga sprawa.
And the second issue is quite strange. And for that, I want to show you a photo to confirm that there are such things in Poland, like double poles. In Kielce, in the city of Kielce, it's just astonishing, you know, the police were called to come there. Two were, people were casting ballots to two boxes instead of one. In Toronto, Canada, we had a lot of reports from all places, and we have a hotline busy all the time. In Toronto, the election commission voted that they would not
przekazania danych przez system informatyczny,
send the data via the IT system, because this is not an obligation, so they will deliver the manual report. First, the consul was against that, and there was a dispute with the consul in Toronto over that.
But,
well, we are happy that the postulate of the commission was accepted eventually. So our request is, please inform all the other election stations and places that the manual report is the one which should be valid and as a source,
so
instead of having such disputes every now and again. Now, as regards this last issue, well, the basis for publishing the official results, well, it's always been the paper reports. As regards the commissions outside the country, well, we have so far received from them 54 voting reports, because in some of those places the polls have been closed already. Now, as regards the foreign international monitors, 100 people were accredited or accepted as monitors. They come from four countries. So we discussed that earlier today. Some things have been explained. But at the first conference, there were reports about problems with access to the polling stations by foreign monitors. We've checked that, and what we found was that in Sulejówek outside Warsaw, the monitor wanted to get in before the place was open, and he asked to make some photos, and he did. He was allowed to do so as he asked, and I must stress that entering the polling station is possible only to people holding appropriate certificate. We cannot allow just passers-by to walk in and out whenever they want to. So these cases where somebody was not allowed in, international monitors were not let in, it was because they didn't just produce the certificate. So we have, what we've done is that everywhere where this problem was the case, we investigated whether that person was actually a monitor. We checked the data, personal data of those persons, and then they were allowed into the building and into the polling station. But, you know, at first they did not produce the certificates. So, you know, it was their fault, in fact, not of the commission. Well, back to the photo. This was in Kielce, wasn't it? Well, that may be caused by the fact that one box was already full up. Because, look, there is one more over there. It's a backup one. We will give you all the whereabouts of that place. Number 19 in Kielce, I think it is.
Postaramy się wyjaśnić, co było powodem.
We'll try to find out what, why was that.
Proszę bardzo, panie redaktorze.
Bartłomiej Bublewicz, Onet,
Polska. Well,
there was an event on one of the social media and the thousands of people respond to it, but they say that in the past sometimes the ink was disappearing from the ballots or was turning into a black patch, so they brought their own pens with them. Well, what would you, how would you comment this fear of many people, this concern? Well, we've discussed that at previous conferences. We also watch what happens on the internet. Well, there is no reason why people could not use their own pens or candles to protect the to prevent adding illegal access to the ballot. We're not against that at all. You can write with whatever you want to. You can use the committee's pen or your own. TVN24, please give us some more examples of any incidents that took place in the recent hours, because knowing, can you now, after these hours, can you predict with more precision when the final results will be available? Well, this is the press conference on the turnout. It was 15 minutes late. And the question of the results, well, probably it will also be a little bit delayed, maybe not by days, but only some minutes, I hope. And you asked about some more events. Well, Mr. Strzelczyk will elaborate on that. Judging by the reports that reach us, well, I must say that, as usual, with this huge mass of people coming and voting, well, things tend to happen. And I could say that most of those events were some breaches of the pre-election silence, sometimes, you know, sticking posters at some places, you know, on the cars, for example. Right? No matter when exactly that poster was put on the car, well, it depends on the time when it was placed there, whether it is a breach of the silence or not. Some more incidents, well, the voters sometimes are not totally sober when they come to the polls, so that's part of the events. It's mostly men, after all, and they try to quarrel there, and they used offensive language, so the police were called, and they were usually solving such events.
There is one
case that the Electoral Commission member was after a few drinks, probably. I don't know right now how that was solved, but we will definitely have that described in the voting report, because the Commission must mention that in the documents. There was one case of in which a signature on the list of voters, somebody signed that person before, so the police are investigating, because they have to clarify what happened. Maybe it was just a mistake, because the lists, people sign the lists when they take the ballots from the commission, and then they turn this list around, and maybe somebody just put the signature in the wrong line. This is possible. We don't know it yet. Let's wait and see. There were no major incidents in the course of the vote, and all I know is updated about these events is updated until 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Please use the microphone. Okay. Marzena Kozłowska, Polish Press Agency. A technical question from me. When you compare this to the previous conference, the number of eligible voters has changed. How is that possible?
Faktycznie w tym komunikacie z godziny 12 wskazano
yes, at 12 o'clock there were 168,000, now it's 229,000. This may be connected with the people who were added to the lists in the meantime, but that's some 60,000 votes. Not more. We're going to clarify that, and we will tell you what we found when you come to the next conference. Thank you for this question. TVP Maria Kutnowska. The voters say that they cannot always find the red seal of the commission on the ballots. How will those ballots be counted? Somebody cast a ballot into the box and then realize, oh, there was no seal on it. Well, it should not happen that there is no seal on the ballot. If before casting the vote, that could be easily solved, but afterwards, you know, the commission should mention that in the report that one or two or three such ballots were cast into the box. Especially that the voters not only vote, but they also watch the process of the election, and I think those people can take care of it to make sure that whenever at least these cases should be mentioned in the report. But according to the law, such votes would be considered not valid without the seal. Any more questions, please? Go ahead, please. Niepoprawne radio, Marek Detua. The election monitoring movement receives a lot of reports that deceased people were present on the list of voters and people who have left the country, and they informed the commission about the fact, but they are still in the list. Is the national commission also receiving such reports? We are sure that it's dozens of people, dozens of cases. We have a lot of such reports. Right. The second issue is the very special way in which the list is given to the voters to be signed. You see, persons in the list above and below the voter, the particular voter, are being obscured. So, well, suppose somebody knows very well that the grandfather had died some time ago, but if that grandfather is still present in the list, it will not be seen, it cannot be checked, you know.
Nie dotarły do nas żadne sygnały tego typu, że
well, we have not received any such reports so far that the deceased people would still be present in the list or those who moved out of the country. But that may happen, after all. And that's what we tried to discuss before the election, when we talked about the proper way of making the lists. But as regards the obscuring the persons above and below the line in which the voter comes, because you know, there is the secrecy issue involved here, right? Why should anyone see who was voting before? But as a matter of fact, both are situations are not regulated by the law, in fact, unless you think otherwise. Well, I believe that, you know, it's not only the family who are close in several lines in the list. They may be strangers, you know, and why should they see too much? The particular voter, if he does not see who is above and below, it's all right. Well, so long as it is a family, but if it's a neighbor, for example, or some other stranger, well, sometimes we know that our neighbors have left the country a long time ago, and we might report that to the commission as a mistake, see? And if it's obscured, but it should be the person who left the country should report. Yes, and they have done that many times. Or sometimes people who died 15 years ago, how can they report the fact to the commission? But these are most single cases and they have to be handled separately on the individual basis. Well, when you report the fact, we will do the rest. Any more questions? No questions, I reckon. Thank you very, very much. So this is the last meeting today. Well, we'll try to... Somebody here will be probably available for you about 9 in the night to come to meet you and perhaps give you some more information when the polls are closed. It's 15 past 9, just a few minutes after 9 o'clock, because, you know, communication, however fast it takes, a little time too. Thank you very, very much. Thank you.